Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to today's webcast titled Cherry Picking Techniques to Find Winning Trades. My name is Brian D'Amico, and I'm the Manager of Educational Services here at VectorVest. My pleasure to be your moderator today for the webcast. Today's instructor is Todd Schaefer. He's the Manager of Research here at VectorVest, and he's been with us for over 7 years now, and he's taught seminars all over the world on both stock and option trading, so it's great to have him here with us today. Today he's going to be teaching us how to cherry pick stocks, you know, the three very popular cherry picking techniques to find winning trades, something you could all do basically starting tomorrow, some very easy techniques. Throughout the webcast, you will be able to submit questions. So there is a little question panel in your GoToWebinar box in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. So everyone just kind of take a quick look up there, look up into the upper right-hand corner. If it did minimize it, just look for a little orange arrow and click on that. But look up in the upper right-hand corner. Do me a favor. Let me know you see it. Just type in into that chat box. Let us know where you're listening in from, you know, city, state. How's the weather? Are you buried in snow? I'm just going to chat in the box there. There we go. Hey, Rick. Good. He says, good to go. Dave, where are you from? Leamington, Ontario. All right. Eugene from Calgary. Okay, they're going a little fast now, so I can't quite keep up. Let's see, Glenn Mills, John, welcome, John. Richard, welcome. All right, looks like you guys found that box. All right, great. I'll say hello to all. So, Ken, welcome. Scott, welcome. Robert, welcome. Great to have you all here, by the way. So throughout the webcast, if you see something just that you have a question about, type it in the chat box. You might want to wait a little bit to see if Todd comes back and covers it. Because he's pretty good about making sure he covers all the points that you're interested in. But we will have a Q&A session at the end where we'll cover all the main questions that we see come in. But for now, I'm going to turn it over to Todd. Welcome, Todd.
Thank you very much, Brian. I appreciate that nice introduction. And hello, folks. Welcome to Lesson 3, Cherry Picking Techniques to Find Winning Trades. I appreciate you all being with us today. And boy, you know, I've got the heart palpitations. It's either the fourth cup of coffee that I'm drinking or my excitement to get this lesson going. Lots of great information that I'm going to share with you on this lesson, and it's not terribly complicated either. So that's a win-win, and the VectorVest tools, of course, make it very easy to apply these techniques. Cherry-picking techniques or stock charting techniques are a very broad topic, and of course there are people who have devoted their lives to understanding and developing these techniques, and so in the course of an hour here, we're not going to get terribly deep into that, but we're going to give you some broad brush strokes that work very well. Let's get started, I suppose, by moving into the program here. All I have to do is figure out how to make that happen. There we go. Of course, here's the front page of the VectorVest software. I want to start out by laying out what we're looking for broadly when we go to do these cherry picking techniques. And we're not looking for chart formations, you know, triangles or pennants or any of those considerations. What we're looking for is that VectorVest simple idea. Those of you who've been around for any time in the VectorVest approach, what we like fundamentally, it's our mantra, is that we like safe, undervalued stocks that are rising in price, and we like to buy them in rising markets. So the underlying behavior that we're looking for in stocks is that they have a nice, consistent bottom left to upper right price performance, driven by the same kind of earnings performance. So let's begin by going into the stock viewer. Here's a stock viewer. We're listed by VST, but for purposes of illustration, I'm going to resort our list by a VectorVest proprietary indicator called Comfort Index. Comfort Index is on a 0 to 2 scale, like many of our proprietary indicators are, and stocks that have strong Comfort Index ratings have a propensity of their price consistently going upward. We like to say that in the strict definition that they have a persistent price movement. So those are the kinds of stocks we're chasing, right? Those are the ones that we like. And so I have a list of stocks here now sorted by Comfort Index descending. And if I look at the graphs of the top I guess we can look at the top 30 and drag that over here to the window so you all can see it. Let's set up our chart here a little bit. I'm looking at a basic graph layout that we call VectorVest Simple. And at its heart, we look for price and we look for earnings. And let's change our price from a line graph. To a candlestick chart. We're looking at a one-year time frame, and what we're looking for typically is bottom left to upper right price movement as smooth as possible, bottom left earnings to upper right as smooth as possible. The idea here is kind of a momentum play of a stock that's been doing this price pattern, this price behavior for the past year, is likely to continue doing so if it has an earnings pattern that's telling us that that company, as their price is increasing, so is their earnings performance. That rise in earnings performance is the engine that keeps driving that higher valuation. So that the earnings is the engine driving that bus. The reason we're looking for smooth patterns is because what you see is what you're going to get. So a stock that has a lot of volatility tends to continue being a volatile stock. And the fact that you bought it yesterday doesn't necessarily change any of that. So if you're hoping to see it just go straight up from where you bought it, then you probably have been disappointed and probably will continue to be. But as we look at these graphs, just look at the kind of, I want you to have a snapshot impression of that graph. We have a saying around here that says if you're looking at a graph longer than 7 seconds, you're trying to convince yourself of something. So just look at these graphs, ask yourself the question, wow, would I buy that stock tomorrow? Right? Do I like that? Am I seeing that bottom left to upper right performance? This is an ETF, and so it has no earnings performance. Right? So there's some volatility, gaps, it goes, extends a gap in channel. Right? Pretty. Right? So overall, just general impressions, you're having a gut reaction, and it's not right or wrong, it's your gut reaction. And what I want you to do is kind of develop this feel for what am I looking for. And when you see a chart like this, you say, well, gee, I don't want to buy this stock. It's already made its move. My retort is, well, then I'm looking at a year now. Well, if you didn't want, if it's made its move, then you didn't want to buy it after this high or 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 this high, and you don't want to buy it now. The concept here is that when we get stocks that are exhibiting these kinds of behaviors, they tend to continue performing. And we're going to play on that. And so ultimately, all the cherry picking techniques that we're going to talk about today are driven by this example. Now, stocks can go, they can trend in three ways or move in three directions. They can trend upward, which is a series of higher highs and higher lows. They can trend downward, a series of lower highs and lower lows. Or you can have a mixture where they're trading sideways. What we're trying to do is when we're bullish on the market and on the stocks, of course, we're trying to identify those stocks that are in those upward price trends. So that being said, there are a couple things that we do that help us identify those kinds of moves. One of the easiest ways to indicate a trend, I think, for most folks, the first of our technical indicators would be to add a moving average of any stripe, really, to price action. And, of course, the longer the look-back period, the less volatile that line is, right? So if price is a one-day moving average, the longer the look-back period of the moving average, the smoother the line. And look what a nice job this 40-day moving average does of being a kind of a self-adjusting trend line for this particular stock. So when I see this sloping upward, this trend line, or this moving average line sloping upward, it's a pretty good indication that at least in this time frame, that this stock has a nice upward trend. There's another indicator in the VectorVest toolbox, and there's a hint, it's right over here. It's also based on a moving average, the VectorVest stop price. The VectorVest stop price, if you recall from your lesson one conversation. The VectorVest stop price is based on a 13-week moving average of the stock's price. We adjust it for the fundamental strength of the company. Companies that have weak fundamentals will make the adjustment so that the line is closer to price to get you out of them faster. But companies with strong fundamentals will actually move that stop price away from price action to keep you in them longer, because they should be more resilient to profit taking and any downward price movements. So that's the VectorVest stop price, again, based on that moving average. Well, there are two tools that we're going to use today that are going to help us identify the stocks that are doing this kind of price behavior in particular. And the first of them is a study that we call the Midas Touch. Now, we did a strategy of the week, actually several strategies of the week, on the Midas Touch graphing layout, if you will. It was originally designed as a timing system for gold. Here I'm clicking on the Midas Touch graph layout that you have for in your graphing tool. Everybody has it. When I click on that layout, we change some of our parameters. But what I want you to do is think about how this is similar to what we just saw in those original graphs that we were watching. We were looking for that nice smooth bottom left to upper right movement in stocks price, right? But now, instead of looking at earnings on the subgraph, we're looking at a moving average of RT. So let's set up the graph. We have on our top graph now a moving average of our VectorVest stop price, the moving average of a moving average. We have a 10 period and a 65 period moving average of the stop price. Right? So if you think of every moving average as it smooths that data line to some degree, we've really smoothed a smoothed line. This kind of analysis works very well for trending kinds of stocks. Right? So highly volatile kinds of stocks, moving averages tend to whipsaw when they get into that kind of price behavior. What I'd have you do is, if I put the price on this chart, do those lines do a pretty good representation of that stock's price movement? Remember, though, they're based on moving averages of stop price. Notice how each line has less volatility. And that's ultimately what this graph is doing for us. Now, let's talk about the RT side of this. It just occurred to me there might be a better way for me to explain this. Let's go back. I'm going to change the layouts here. Back to the VectorVest layout. This is RT, relative timing, for Arkansas's Best. Stocks that have high CI ratings tend to have RT values that stay above 1 because they have persistent uptrends. So by looking for stocks with good RT moving averages, accelerating RT, we're, in a sense, looking for stocks that have good CI ratings. Midas Touch, the Midas Touch layout, takes advantage of that by using, as one of its indicators, a moving average on relative timing of 40 days or 40 periods. So what we have now is, I'm still looking at a one-year time frame. I have those moving averages of stop price, and I have a moving average of RT. 40-period moving average. Notice how RT through all this time frame, even back here, the moving average is staying above 1, right? Even though there's some volatility in the line. So what we look for, and maybe if I expand this we'll see the crossover, what we're looking for as an entry point here is when you have the RT value cross above 1, the RT moving average value cross above 1, coincided with the moving averages of stop price crossing over in a bullish pattern. So the short term above the long term. That's your entry point into this stock. And of course, came back here in December and it's been trucking ever since. Okay? But what I want you to think about is, we scroll through these graphs And by the way, it's not a coincidence that they cross in a relatively consistent time frame, because what drives price action? Market action, right? So it's not surprising to me that they're all fairly close. I'm looking for the crossover here. So the next tick, not quite on the moving average. I might have gotten in here a little bit. It wavered a little bit before it really started ticking off. But just on a chart basis here, this is something you can look for. So I'm going to, in this case, with the Midas touch, I'm looking for the best entry is not here where RT may pull back, is when RT is just crossing from below to above 1 and is confirming this positive orientation of the moving averages. So a great way to stock or to cherry pick then is to simply look through that list of stocks and visually check for that pattern. It's naturally taking you or leading you to, again, if I put on the price pattern, price drives it all, right? It broke out of this downward, I'm doing the smile effect here, broke out of this downward consolidation, started trending upward again, and that was evidenced by the crossover in the RT moving average and those slower moving averages on stop. So play with this setup a little bit and see if you don't think that there's a pretty good correlation between these studies crossing over and the beginning of stock uptrends. Okay, so that's cherry picking technique number one, the Midas touch. Again, all of this is driven in our pursuit of finding stocks that are exhibiting those price patterns we saw in our idealized graphs. It's all about trying to find stocks that consistently rise in price, driven by consistently rising earnings. Okay, so I think you get the idea here. Some very nice graph patterns. We had actually a subscriber suggest an enhancement to this technique called Colt 45. Colt is a nice little acronym that says coefficient of line trends. But basically the idea is if we shorten our time frame from a year, so instead of looking for this crossover, we're going to tighten our time frame to 3 months, which I'm going to have to do manually here apparently because resolution is too high. Oh, right there, yay! This is an extension of the logic that we just shared. And so let's think about it. What we have now, we still have the same moving averages, right? The graph setup is the same. The only thing we've done is we're now limiting our look back period, our visual look back period here, to 3 months. The look back periods on the indicators are the same. What we're looking for now is in this shorter time frame, we want to see that relative timing, the moving average is continuing to increase. So we want it to be currently at a new high for the past 3 months. It's helpful to change your cursor from a dateline here to a crosshair. And when I come to the current time frame, that horizontal line shows me that I'm off of the high which occurred back here. So this is not a candidate because RT is not hitting a new high. The other thing that I want to have, once I have an RT that is hitting a new high, above 1, by the way, hitting a new high, I want to see that my moving averages are in their proper arrangement, where the short term is higher than the long term, both of them hitting a new 3-month high. So if the red line, the 65-day moving average, had started up here and then come down before it finished here, it would be rejected because it wasn't at a new 3-month high. So the easy way to use this technique is to scroll forward. Here I have RT is at a new high. Look for RT first. Your second consideration then come to the top two lines. Green above red, perfect, and both of them at a new 3-month high. So BIB is a candidate. And lo and behold, if you put price there, what's price doing? A series of higher highs and higher lows doing exactly what we want it to do. And it's building in momentum. So this study is very easy to apply. So if you're not a great technician, right, then this is a very easy way to kind of apply the rules and go through any list of stocks, either whether it's a search return, whether it's the stock viewer, whether it's a list of stocks you got from another source. Doesn't matter. This is a great way to look for these trends. The one thing I would say is remember, though, that we're still looking at relatively long look-back periods, right? So this is more of a trending approach, a position trading approach, than it is a day trading approach, right? Because these are longer look-back periods. That's where the majority of us are, so that's why we're presenting it, right? But just as you scroll through here, then you can very quickly pick out the candidates who are candidates. This one doesn't work because it was, the RT is not a new high. And so you can see how easy that is to point out. What I'm hoping to find here as I scroll through here quickly is I'm looking for something with price action that fails, which is harder because I have such good CI stocks in my list. I'm not finding any. And we're to the bottom of the list. So price action worked on all those, but of course remember just that these have to be at new highs for the three-month period. All right, so that's the Colt 45 methodology, but I want you to understand just conceptually, this is just leading us to those patterns that we saw when we looked at the graphs manually looking at the price, the raw price data. These are just easier ways to get to that point. So that's, I guess, technique number 2.5. I guess I haven't really numbered these, but that's using the Midas Touch, a variant of the Midas Touch called Colt 45. Again, strategy of the week presentations that we can lead you to that show the setup and how it works, if you want more detail than what I'm giving you here. To do this next technique, I need to change our layout, and I'm going to go back to that VectorVest simple layout. But this time, I'm going to take off relative timing and earnings. Let's change our price back to, why am I doing that today? To candlesticks, and let's go back to our one-year time frame. And I'm going to add a parameter to our graph. That parameter is comfort index. Comfort index, again, on a 0 to 2 scale, right? So here's the neutral line of 1, in this case, where comfort index crossed from below to above 1, right? Particularly a nice entry point for the stock. One of the questions, actually, let's look at a couple graphs and just how that uptrend in CI coincides with the uptrend in that price performance. Ooh, that had a lot of noise, right? So, do I like noise? No. I like smooth bottom left, upper right. All right, so that would not pass my test. But hopefully what's dawning on you is, well, these are nice, Todd. They're nice, pretty, beautiful graph patterns, but you're showing them to me here. Would you mind showing them to me here? This uses a technique we call CI up-and-comers. What we're doing now is we're going to apply a study to comfort index by again applying some moving averages. Let's move back to the top stock, and we have a graph layout, and this should be built for everyone in your graphing tool, called CI Sweet Spot. CI Sweet Spot applies some moving averages to the comfort index indicator, specifically a 10-day and a 20-day look back. So now I have CI, which is a 1-day look back, so now I have a 1, a 10, and a 20. And in this technique, what we're looking for is accelerating comfort index. And see this fanning effect. See how the three moving averages, not only did they cross over and be oriented so that they're 1, 10, and 20, but they're also separating, showing acceleration in that indicator. And this is a great indication when the price performance changes from basing to trending. You'll see this explosion or this fanning effect of the comfort index. So let's look at the effect first of all. Notice how this has the effect, but look how much noise there is in the data. if you still worked, I mean, if you still traded it, that was the beginning of a trend. It broke down here a couple times. All right, so comfort index is still working. We just want to see less noise in the indicator. Okay. When we get that fanning effect, it's a great entry point. Fanning effect, great entry point. Notice how we're on a 0 to 2 scale, right? And the momentum of this indicator starts to trail off as you get to the elevated levels. Well, we're trying to catch them early, which is why we're looking for that fanning effect. A lot of noise in MDSO. We saw that in the original CI indicator. Beautiful fanning effect here, right? That was a great keeper, if you will. These are particularly looking for entry points, right? And we might try some other techniques in terms of finding the exits or the breakdown in that momentum. All right, but again, that fanning effect, you can see this one worked a couple times as that stock tends to thrust forward and base a little bit. Lots of noise. Still rather noisy. Had a couple periods in there that worked. All right, but when in doubt, I say when in doubt, leave it out. I want to see this nice pattern. If I don't see that nice pattern, then I'm moving on. So this is another great cherry-picking technique to help you identify stocks whose trends are strengthening or taking off. Okay. In the Unisearch tool, we also have searches that help us find stocks that are behaving this way. So in the Unisearch tool, actually, I just sorted alphabetically. Let's start here. In the cherry-picking folder, CI Sweet Spot, CI Up and Comers. Notice that we're looking for stocks, right, who have crossed their 1 day, is above the 10-day, which is above the 20-day. Values above one. Yeah, so you see some of those parameters in there. And what we're doing is we're looking for candidates by virtue of their data points. You can run that search and then go to the results and cherry pick from those results stocks that are just exhibiting. Let's go to a 3-month graph. I'm in this nice trend pattern and look how they're just starting to fan out again, right? We're just catching that fan out as it starts. Hopefully some of them have already been established, but right, that's what you want to look for. You know, we've been in this one now for about 2 weeks or so. You know, is that breaking down? Is it moving on still? Okay, so the searches can help you find those candidates to then get through that list of 8,000 stocks to find candidates that you're actually interested in trading. Notice right below that we have Colt 45 Automated, which now looks for stocks, this one on the S&P 500, but of course delete the watch list and you can look broadly at the whole market for stocks that are exhibiting those moving average crossovers and the 40-day RT moving average. So I run that search on today's close. I would graph all of these guys. And because I'm looking for the Colt 45 signal, I would change my layout to the Midas Touch on a 3-month period. And I can quickly and easily, remember this one was look for RT and then confirmed with price action. You scroll down and find your candidates. Here's one that's just tapering off so that we rejected him because he's losing price momentum. All right, we're looking for building price momentum. And, ooh, look how the red line, the slower moving average, the 65-day moving average, almost upside down here on Pulte Homes. Right? Had it been above my current price of that moving average, then I would have rejected that as not being at a new 3-month high. So there we have it, very simply, very straightforward. We've got some different techniques of trying to find stocks that are giving us those price patterns, those persistent price performing patterns. Try to find them quickly and easily using the tools in VectorVest and then visually just popping through them and confirming their efficacy as a candidate. One last piece I want to give you because it's related to this, Brian had done a webinar on when to sell. And so we've done some strategy presentations and webinars on selling in general and about some of the things that we look for as indications that the stock's price is breaking down. One of the things you can look for, it ties in very well, is in this Colt 45 layout. Let's do this. Let's go back to the stock viewer, and I'm going to sort it by RT. Ascending here. I didn't stop talking, sorry. I want to try to find somebody who's kind of more middle of the pack. And I'm winging it here a little bit, folks, but bear with me here. So I'm going to graph these guys. And I'm sorry, I just graphed all. How about graph select? And here's what we're looking for. We're on that Midas touch layout again, right? When you see this RT moving average start to break down, what's that mean? Well, I don't really need you to type in the answer because there's too many of you. But basically that means that we're breaking down in that RT momentum, right? That we're starting to lose that acceleration. So we can start looking for breakdown in price along with that breakdown in RT. And so using this layout can be very helpful. Using the same stock or stock graphing tool on the stocks you already own can be very helpful in identifying when the momentum is breaking down on your stock. And when that's the case, then if we simply look at the price and look for a break in that trend, the stock's no longer hitting higher highs, it broke a new low, right? So if that was, as I noticed trend was breaking down, I might say, okay, well, there's the low, all right? If price breaks below that low, which it did over here, then I'm out. Or depending on where I looked, maybe it was up here, right? So that becomes then my place of my line in the sand, if you will, to exit the position on a cherry-picking graph analysis point of view. All right, so that's my presentation for you on some stock-picking techniques, some cherry-picking techniques. Again, we're just looking for that idealized graph pattern of a nice, steadily rising price. Hopefully driven by nice, steady, rising earnings. And with that, let's get Brian back involved, and let's see if I can handle any questions for you about applying these techniques.
Great. Thanks, Todd. Nice job. We've got a number of questions that have come in. I've got some people, I'll let you know, I was going to answer have Todd answer those questions at the end, which is why you didn't get an answer during the webcast from me. So let me try to hit up as many as we can here, Todd. Let's see. The one I flagged here. Now, some of these might refer back to any one of those three that you were showing. So maybe next time we do the webcast, we'll take a break after each time we show a technique and just answer questions for each technique.
That's a nice idea. Good idea.
All right. So this one is from Frank. He says, "Would you not buy a stock that has risen above the moving average?" I'm not sure which technique he was referring to when you were showing that, but
would I not buy it because it rose above its moving average? You can. I mean, that's a moving average crossovers are a technical indicator, and a lot of people use them. The problem that you have with moving averages, though, is that they break down in non-trending price action. So, for instance, if I graph these, I'm just going to graph top 10 here. I'm sure some of these will have sideways action somewhere. And we'll put on. Why am I doing that today, Brian? I've got this thing. I don't want to change the type. I want to change the style.
I'm not sure.
Okay. I don't know either. Breaking down. All right, so let's say we were doing, you know, price crossing the moving average as my entry point. Well, when you get into sideways moving price action, it becomes very difficult, right? And how do you know whether this turn is the last turn before the uptrend starts? Also, what do you do with this, right? What if it just comes back and kind of touches the line, barely crosses over, but then keeps on going? Right now, some people say, well, let's put on another moving average, right? Let's add a 40-day moving average. Say, okay, that's fine. We can do that. It'll slow down a little bit. That's not a problem. And the crossovers give you a better kind of on-off switch, if you will. Bo, did you close out right here? What did you do right here? Right? Stock had been moving sideways for a little while. I don't know. Of course, you got out here, and then you got right back in 10 days later. So not to say that moving averages aren't good. I'm just saying they each of these tools has their strengths and their weaknesses. Ultimately, what I find a lot of new traders do in particular is they are very nervous about trying to hold Arkansas Best through this price action. Very nervous. Anytime you get a pullback and you're down more than about 5 points, they're ready to sell the stock, right? That, speaking from personal experience, that was the hardest part of my discipline was I was afraid to take a loss, right? So I had a hair trigger stop mentality where I was trying to get out of anything and hold on to my 3% gain, right? So there's a lot to be said about backing up, try to ascertain where this thing is really going, what are the fundamentals of the company, what are the fundamentals of the market, are things getting a little skitterish, are earnings starting to taper off like we're seeing a lot of stocks do now, you know, that's showing some signs of weakening. So those are the kinds of things that come together as you analyze these stocks and, you know, what kind of hair trigger you want to have on them. Over.
I knew you'd say it. All right. Let's see. Casey asked, he had a few questions here. Let me see if I can put them all together in one. Let's see. So let me get through all three here. He says, so to sort any stock, you just hit the top letters. I'm guessing that means on in the viewer's screen. And then the next question was, this is Colt 45. Is it for stocks in a good trend already? And another question about, does it work on tops? When to get out, when to exit, or just on entries. So I don't know if that helped, you know, piecing three different things together there, but right. You're usually great at piecing these together, Todd.
What I would say is the Colt 45 look for the topping action, you know, when it's breaking down, you're looking for that RT moving average to start rolling over. As soon as it's hitting a lower value, look at price action and go back to the previous low and set a stop loss there or maybe a point below it. Right? That's your threshold of, because this uptrend, by definition, is over when I hit a lower low. Right? So this uptrend ended when I hit a lower low. So by definition, then, if I set a threshold, stop threshold here, maybe even, you know, point below it, when I break through that, then by definition, the trend is over and I either want to be protected or out of it. I certainly want to be aware of it, right? So that RT breakdown shows you that this trend overall is breaking down, not that you just had some, you know, erratic price movement. So that's much more helpful in terms of slowing you down. Now, one of the things, you know, one of the other things I didn't think of during this is when you see price action like that, there's two places that I want you to be careful of. A 45-degree slope to price action is considered to be sustainable in most technical circles. When the price action starts going up at a higher rate than that, we call that going parabolic. Often you'll see the price action going flat, and then it kind of does this curve and starts going up and does the rocket ship blast off thing. This is not considered to be sustainable, and what you'll often see is after that price run-up, you'll see a strong profit-taking session where the price drops precipitously double digits, right? So buying in at the tail end of this is more fraught with risk because you don't know how soon before the musical chairs stops and whether or not you build up enough profit before you stop out. So what technique you might do here, and this also goes with gapping action, is wait to see when that profit taking happens, wait for it to resume its uptrend, and then jump back on the parade or the bandwagon once the negative price action has ended and the uptrend resumes. You'll see that a lot. Here's an example. We had a gap up in action, right, and then trade sideways. There are a lot of technicians who would set a stop limit order above that resistance point. If the stock gaps up again, they'll take it for the next ride. But really, the idea here is you want to see that nice 45-degree price appreciation as the better play. Notice how we gapped here, consolidated again. I'm interested in the stock if it starts trending upward again. Okay. What's next, Brian?
All right. Well, before I get to Mike's question, but he asked a question about searches. The two searches that you showed, I think it's worth noting that they do require a ProTrader functionality.
Yes, thank you. I forgot to mention that.
One or two people said that if you don't see those searches, and if you want to go back to those really quick, Todd, if you don't see those two searches he was showing, the Colt 45 automated, I believe it was CI Sweet Spot, those have a ProTrader. Was it CI Sweet Spot or was it, what was the other one? CI Up and Comers? Mm-hmm. They use a ProTrader feature, so if you don't have ProTrader add-on, you wouldn't see those searches. So those kind of automate what Todd was showing there. Mike's question is this. Let's see, where I lost it here. He says, can you create a unit search to identify the following? And I think we kind of answer it with one of these searches. And it's the moving average of relative timing, the moving average of stop hitting new highs. So basically the 10 and the 65-day of stop hitting a new high, and the moving average of relative timing hit a new high. Do we have something that'll do that or something close?
We don't have. We only have a new high on price action. We used to have it, but with real-time data, there were some technical reasons where we aren't able to support it. And that's why the cherry-picking aspect of this is still required. Because even though I know these moving averages are higher than each other, I don't know that they're at three-month highs. And that's why you need to still physically look at the chart. We're supposedly working on that, but I don't have any release dates or anything in terms of finding new highs on non-price indicators.
All right. Ready for another one?
Yep.
All right. A couple people asked what the 45 meant in Colt 45, and I just let them know it's a 45-degree angle that the lines make on the chart, basically lower left to upper right.
Idealized, yeah, you'd have that fanning action with 45-degree slopes.
And Jerry had a follow-up to that. He's like, 45-degree angle, does that basically mean like a 30% annualized rate of return? Yeah, I'm not sure if we can put a number to that, but if you had a comment on that.
I don't. I haven't thought of that at all.
Yep. I don't think we can kind of say one matches the other. Let's see. And while I'm looking for another quick question, some people were asking if there'd be a recording, and yes. If Todd, could you do me a favor? Just go to our website, go to VectorVest.com, and then go and just type VectorVest.com/events. All right, so if all of you who are interested in recordings, if you go to VectorVest.com/events, obviously at the top we have our live events, which you can register for. Those are the ones where you can go into a hotel and see us. And if you scroll down a little bit, there are the upcoming webcasts. And then below that, there's an archived webcast section where at the top of the list we'll have last week's or the week prior's recordings. But there are some webcasts that we decide to archive for permanent placement there. So there you can see archived lesson 1, archived lesson 2. So those videos there. And give us about a day or two. And we're going to get this one archived as well and listed there. The other thing that to let you know is if Todd actually goes to YouTube, YouTube.com, some of you might not visit YouTube quite a bit, but if you go to YouTube and if Todd just types in VectorVest space SOTW for strategy of the week, and then after the SOTW, Todd, if you could just put a space and then put the word cherry, like you're cherry picking, and hit enter, we've actually been uploading our Strategy of the Week videos since about last April. So this will pull back pretty much all the Strategy of the Week videos where we taught some sort of cherry-picking technique. And you can see a few of them right there at the top where we have cherry-picking with the Midas Touch.
That looks familiar down there.
Yeah, if Todd scrolls down just a little bit, you'll probably see Colt 45. And then a couple on Colt 45 Automated, which goes into using the Unisearch tool. So that's a great little way if you want maybe a little 15-minute video on how to do these things. All right, so those
that reminds
are that.
Me, by the way, Brian, industry leaders, you can do the same kind of analysis. Remember, we analyze industries and sectors just like a stock, so they still have price graphs and they have all the same indicators that stocks do. Great way to find industries that are in favor, to find component stocks within them. Great technique.
All right, so I'm done with YouTube and go back to VectorVest. Let's see.
All right.
Tony asks, when you were showing the, I believe this was when you were showing the Midas Touch, he says, are you not concerned with the up, or actually it was also VectorVest Simple too, are you not concerned about the ups and downs in relative timing, the movement in relative timing?
Actually, let's take a look at some of these. Because the short answer is no, I'm really concerned with the trend, if that makes sense. So let's look at the graphs again. Right. So the RT, right, the noise in the RT line, for instance, how much volatility there is in RT, is not as important to me as whether or not it's hitting higher highs. Right? The trend of RT is more important to me than how much volatility there is. Of course, yeah, I'd rather have less volatility, all things being equal. But I want to make sure that it's continuing to hit higher highs. It's when that trend starts to break down, when you start seeing it hit lower highs, the price action starts to flatten out. That's what I'm trying to avoid, if you will. I want to see that accelerating over time. Now, the thing that gets people crazy in RT is RT can stay elevated for quite a long time. 1.94, 191, 186. What's the price? The price is still moving upward. 186 is a little bit slower than 191, but it's still accelerating upward at a pretty good rate. Right? So folks are afraid of buying a stock because it's gotten to an RT value of 1.8. Well, there's nothing that says it can't go higher or maintain that relatively high rate for quite some time. That in and of itself is not a reason to not buy the stock. But again, the trend is what we're reeling for, and that's why that moving average is so effective in assessing the trend of that RT indicator. You can, by the way, right-click on RT, add a moving average. Right. And any moving average just smooths that line for you so you can tell what the real trend is. Brian?
All right, so Trevor just wanted a recap. You might have done this while I looked away. He says, just to clarify then, a good entry point would be when both RT and the 10 and 65-day moving average of stops are hitting new highs. And he says, was that the Midas Touch?
That was the Colt 45. The Midas Touch looks for the crossover of RT from below, the moving average of RT from below to above 1 with the fanning effect of the stop price moving averages. So
okay.
Again, let's just lay it out. Here's the Midas Touch. We're looking for the crossover of the RT moving average coinciding with the fanning of the moving averages. Colt 45 narrows the time frame to 3 months, and now I'm looking for RT to be at a new high and that the price, the stop price moving averages are both at new highs and in correct fanning orientation. Hopefully that helps.
All right. With Colt 45, this is from a longtime subscriber. David asks, with Colt 45, when's the best time to exit know, would you use your typical stops, basically, or is there a technique on when to exit those trades?
Well, universally, any exit technique, trailing stops, price trend analysis, technical indicator, all of those are in vogue and available to you. One of the ones I like is the one I showed you here where I look for that breakdown in RT. So if I was trading this stock, for instance, and I saw the price that RT started breaking down, when I came into this graph, what I would do is I'd say, well, I'm not going to just sell it because RT broke down. Maybe it's just kind of pausing and like it did before, and it's about to take off again. So what I'll do is I'll set my line in the sand. I'll let it run. If it resumes and it resumes its uptrend, great. No harm done. But if it does break down, I've now set my line in the sand that I'm going to, you know, capture as much of the profit as I can before it starts to break down. Meanwhile, all this time where I was building momentum in RT, I could be fairly lax on these pullbacks and not get overly excited just because it would pull back a couple percent. And that's what I perceive as being the benefit of this methodology in terms of, let's see if I can find another example here. Not a good one. I'm cycling now. Here we go. Here's one that's just starting to break down, right? So I noticed that it started dropping, right? So right about here, I'm saying, okay, well, there's my last pullback. That's my support level. Let's see what it does from here. I like the idea, especially if if you're in the habit of taking profits too early and whacking yourself on the back of the head because you sold out too soon. This kind of approach can be helpful in terms of slowing you down. You're still going to lock in your profit, but you're giving the stock a chance to run. That can be real helpful in terms of managing you.
All done?
All done.
David says...
That was the pregnant pause.
David says thanks. You're welcome, David. Some of these might probably would take like a 10 to 15 minute explanation, especially from Todd.
I don't have any short ones. My short explanation box is empty.
Oh, let's see. Mark's quick little comment. Mark says, great info. Thanks. There are a few other positive comments for you there, Todd. But I typically don't like to swell your head too much, so I don't pass those on to you.
I have a very weak self-image, so you can bolster me up all you want.
When you first started, a person had asked where you got those stocks from, and I let them know they were just from the top of the stock viewer. Correct me if I'm wrong. That's where you just started with the stock viewer stocks. Is that correct?
I started with CI. I sorted by CI to get some idealized charts for us to look at. But, you know, that's an interesting little exercise. Anytime, just sort by VST. All right, let's graph the top 10. And tell me if you see decidedly different results here. I'm going to change my layout back to simple. All right, well, what was the first thing? The first pass was just take a look at the chart if you're thinking about it too much. Right? If you're looking at it too long, you're doing it wrong. So, boom. Do you like the pattern, right? You can tell very quickly. I don't have to sit there long. But you can see, boom, the gap jumps right out at you, right? So this is one of those guys that I'm going to hold off for a couple days to make sure that from this point it continues to trend upward, not retrace and fill the gap. I like the earnings pattern, right? They're still making more money. And unlike a lot of these guys that have this flagging earnings pattern, they're still pulling strong. So if I can see, especially right now, I'm favoring stocks that continue to make earnings and are continuing to go upward. Just so happens that that'll have a nice chart pattern in the other two studies as well. In fact, I like that graph, Brian. You like that graph?
Yeah.
I like that graph.
Well, I think at this point, why don't we do this? I'm going to put our our support number in the chat box here. It's 888-658-7638. Some of the questions you put in there can definitely, well, most of them can definitely be answered by one of our consultants on the line. If you just call 888-658-7638, we could definitely help you out. I had a pleasure doing it. This was, of course, another fun webcast. I'm going to pass it over to Todd so he can say his final goodbyes. But, you know, I definitely appreciate you all taking time out of your day to be here and passing it back over to you, Todd.
Absolutely. Thank you, Brian, for funneling through all those questions. We did have a very full room today, so Brian earned his keep. All I had to do was talk. I appreciate that very much. And enjoyed talking with you folks and showing you, hopefully, some simple, easy-to-apply concepts that will help you find winning trades and manage them effectively going forward. That's one of the things I like about the VectorVest system is it gives me the tools so that I can quickly and easily trade what I want to trade and be successful doing it. Here's the link to the VectorVest University if you want to go see some of those videos. And, of course, you can always call us for more help. Thank you again, and have a great rest of the day.